that for India, caffeine is equivalent to coffee.
Yeah.
Now, we can make this brand actually global, and we can grow this brand, penetrate this wonder ingredient of caffeine into the Indian markets, because it's good for both your skin and hair.
Saying sometimes we say don't get addicted, you know, that's all we say about caffeine, just don't get addicted.
It's good to have people addicted to the goodness of caffeine.
If you can tell for the audience to understand, most of the beauty care products require to have animal products in them. Like, is it a
yes.
very normal thing to have so many?
Yes. Not even if you don't have a core product, but a part of the product which is an ingredient might be animal derived ingredient. So that's where probably the entire product is not vegan, but a part of that product which is ingredient is vegan. And a lot of like a honey or a lanolin wax, these are the ingredients which are animal derived, and we don't use any of these ingredients. Wow. That's where we say that we are a vegan brand. And getting addicted to all the good caffeine gives to your skin and hair. Coffee, body washes, we want them to have M-caffeine as their first cup of coffee.
Okay, thank you so much, Vaishali, for finding time for India Podcast. It's real a pleasure to have you with us.
Thanks a lot for having me. It's lovely connecting with you guys and sharing a journey of M-caffeine with you.
Yeah, it's so interesting. Now you are there for the youth. I think the whole brand and product is more youth oriented. We are also the young brand. We are there with the Gen Z connections. It's quite connecting to have you talking about M-caffeine. Before I start, you know, I was just getting ready and I got this coffee wala lip balm, and I was like thinking, like, really coffee is there in the market, you know. Now, Vaishali, we talk about coffee, we only talk about drinking coffee or, you know, what quality brew. I was going through the menu of your product. It seemed like main koi cafe mein baith ke padh rahi hu.
Through
how
so glad.
It all began, like, what led you to make something as a beverage to now go as a you know, body care product or something you would use otherwise?
Journey was very interesting. In the year of 2016, in the beginning of the year, one of my partners and co-founder Tarun Sharma, he had a sore eye, and there was a lot of water retention, puffiness in the eye area, and that's where one of his roommates suggested at that point of time, why don't you keep a green tea bag on your eye? And that was something which was very strange to him at that point of time, and he didn't, out of curiosity, he asked that why do you think that works? Yeah. And he was like that it has caffeine, and caffeine actually reduces all the puffiness in your eyes.
Wow.
And that actually helped, and all the puffiness was gone. That's where we started researching about this ingredient. We all five of us were together at that point of time, doing a bit of our previous venture, working on a bit of our previous venture. That's where we pivoted from that venture to this product venture of us, which is caffeinated personal care. And we did a lot of research. Research went for about 7 to 9 months. Okay. And in the October 2016, we launched M-caffeine range. And then once we started interacting with our consumers, we got to know that for India, caffeine is equivalent to coffee.
Yeah.
That was a very general, I think, sentiment at that point of time. And we got to understand what our consumers are thinking about us, what are their demands. And then we launched our coffee range in 2018, and to our surprise, it went crazy. People were crazy about the body scrub we launched, about our face masks, about our body butters, and it was also exciting for us that we felt that now we can make this brand actually global, and we can grow this brand, penetrate this wonder ingredient of caffeine into the Indian markets, because it's good for both your skin and hair.
You know, as you're saying, sometimes we say don't get addicted, you know, that's all we say about caffeine, just don't get addicted. Does it go in contradicting to your branding agenda? Because somewhere we all want to be conscious, we take caffeine before our workout, or the only thing our parents is just don't get addicted. You start doing some healthy things. So how are you making it sound healthy? Because it can be a little confusing that way, right?
Absolutely. I understand the fear, and it's the right question actually. Very interesting one. We used to hear this particular question a lot of times.
Yeah.
And so this was something which even we thought while we were coming up with this campaign of ours.
Yes.
Which is addicted to good.
Yeah.
As you rightly said, caffeine. The first word which comes to the mind is getting addicted to caffeine.
Yeah.
And all of us are at, I mean, my day doesn't start with coffee. It doesn't start with coffee.
Right? Doesn't start with drinking coffee, but I'm sure you...
Yes, applying one.
Yeah.
So we felt that is it good to have people addicted to the goodness of caffeine?
Wow.
I mean, there's no harm in getting addicted to the good habits in your life.
Yeah.
Getting addicted to veganism, getting addicted to vegan products, clean products, getting addicted to safe products, no toxin products, natural products, getting addicted to all the good caffeine gives to your skin and hair. And that's where we thought that, no, I think that's something we'll have to change. We'll have to change the way we think about caffeine, the way people think about their good habits. You have to get addicted to good, and you have to get addicted to good habits in your life.
This thing. So how do you look at caffeine, M-caffeine, veganism? How do you connect the dots there? Like, is there no milk product? That is what directly comes to our head.
Yes. And we are 100%, we are 100% vegan brand.
Yeah.
None of our products or any of the ingredients used in the products are animal derived or tested on animals. We do not do that. We are 100% vegan brand. Each and every formulation, each and every product of ours is 100% vegan. In fact, we are PETA certified 100% vegan and 100% cruelty free brand.
Just to interfere, if you can tell for the audience to understand, most of the beauty care products require to have animal products in them. Like, is it a very normal thing to have so? And
yes. Not even if you don't have a core product, but a part of the product which is an ingredient might be animal derived ingredient. So that's where probably the entire product is not vegan, but a part of that product, which is ingredient, is vegan. And a lot of like a honey or a lanolin wax, these are the ingredients which are animal derived. And we don't use any of these ingredients.
Wow.
That's where we say that we are a vegan brand. And I think this is one initiative every beauty, every skincare brand in the industry should start taking if they're not. Because
how
I think
does it benefit? Like, what are the benefits of going vegan when you talk about this industry specifically? Does it benefit in a way or into your skincare also? Other than it is definitely benefiting the environment and the you know, disturbing animals, but how does it benefit in the other way? Organic products being
correct. I think one fact is that people are becoming very, very conscious. A part of the community is already conscious about, you know, saving the planet, saving the animal community, being sustainable. But the other part of the community might not be that educated enough or might not have that kind of resources or levers to actually have that kind of a lifestyle. And beauty and skincare being an integral part of anybody's lifestyle at this point of time. When we talk about Gen Zs, when we talk about millennials, skincare, the personal care aspect is very big in their lives, and that's where beauty and personal care segment can take an initiative where we can actually start becoming vegan. All the brands start focusing about sustainability, becoming vegan, and that's, I think, can be the first step into penetrating into the youth and the communities who probably are not aware about vegan.
Now getting to the product, you're having so many lined behind you, I can see. You know, I have a list of your menu and I was reading, I actually got confused. I had to go through it, all looks like a coffee shop car menu. It's like Naked and Raw Cafe, coffee body wash, cappuccino coffee body wash, mocha coffee body wash, latte. What is it?
Yes.
How do one know? Like, if I like mocha, should I go for mocha? How do I choose it?
Got it. Interesting question. First of all, I'll pick up one of our newly launched and the hottest selling products. We have gone out of stock 5 times in this particular category because people are going crazy, and that's our coffee body washes. It comes in a
that's like a coffee mug.
Yes, and this coffee cup is infused with coffee beans, with raw coffee beans.
It is made of that.
It is made of that, and which makes it eco-friendly, biodegradable, hence sustainable for the environment.
Yeah, you have a body wash in that.
Yes, so you just open this nozzle and you'll have the body wash.
So you've not just made the product so connecting, you've also made it very relatable to the whole coffee business. Have you ever thought of doing a tie-up with a coffee brand? Like, is that on
the... We have, and I think a couple of things will definitely be coming out in the next two quarters. But we feel that, I think for a personal care brand, we need to make it exciting, and that's what we are doing. Coffee...
Vaishali, what were the challenges you also had to face, or you still face, when it comes to putting a personal care brand? Because somewhere there's a lot of fixation about personal care brand. People have their own choice and they stay with it for long because it's about their skin, about their hair, and you know, so individual stick. So was it difficult to crack through and bring out the benefits generously and generically, basically to all of the consumers? Because there's certain brands which stay long with a older age group and younger ones as well. So how are you tracking through it?
I think first is RTG is millennials, Gen Zs and millennials. What we feel is personal care has never been exciting in India. We go to a store, we buy a face wash, we buy a body wash with a very specific reason of cleansing our body, cleansing our face, moisturizing our body, moisturizing our face. But if I'm spending 10 minutes in my bathroom, it needs to make me feel good. Yes. It needs to have an excitement for me to go into my bathroom and have a peaceful bath with my products. And that's what we actually worked on. We don't just focus on delivering the efficacy via our products. We build our brand, we build our products with 4 E's. Okay. One is the efficacy. Our products are effective, they are natural, they are made safe. Second is the experience. This is one experience. The coffee fragrance is another. Your bathroom will smell like a cafe once you come out of the bathroom after using any caffeine products. Yeah. The third is the brand ethos. Like we talked about, we are vegan, we are natural, we are made safe. Right? And the fourth is the emotion which gets derived. And that is that's the feeling of goodness. That's a feel-good factor a person feels when he or she's taking bath with a body scrub, with a body wash, with a face wash, and it's their favorite coffee which they were consuming for more than 10 years in their life, more than 15 years in their life, and that's something we integrated into their baths. We want them to have M caffeine as their first cup of coffee.
True.
Right, and feel excited, feel energetic about themselves. Like, so that's the thought.
But coming back to what you were answering, and I changed the question though, was how does one choose? Like, so many coffees I like, so how do you go about it?
Perfect. So I'll just take an example of a espresso versus latte, right? Okay. Espresso is a energy drink and latte is a very comfortable drink.
Yes.
First is we would prefer people who want a quick dose of energy, a quick dose of excitement to go for espresso because of the fragrance in it, because of the kind of products and the formulations. And when we talk about latte, it's very comforting, probably when you're having a low day and you just want to chill on your sofa, we would suggest go for a latte. And the second thing about the efficacy of the product, espresso is made with, it's focused towards giving hydration and exfoliation.
Yes.
Right? Latte is made towards giving you an extra dose of nourishment because it has milk as well with coffee.
Okay.
When we talk about espresso, it's pure coffee. And when we talk about latte,
it's like the black coffee versus...
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct. So that's how you choose the products. We have bifurcated our concerns amongst these five ranges. And then it's for the person to choose what kind of a concern and what kind of a use case would they want to choose with our products.
Okay, and how are you looking at taking it further, a leap up from here? Because now that you've made, I think you're going for making everyone caffeine smelling, and you know, feel good about their coffee. And if you're not able to go to a cafe, just go for a shower with any caffeine. I think that's enough to feel
exactly
a coffee outside. What's the next step, Vaishali? Because you have quite penetrated in Indian market. I think 18,000 pin codes. Is that true?
Yeah.
How did you do it? I think our Indian post office.
One thing is that what we realized was why we wanted to serve 18,000 pin codes at first place, because coffee is something which every person is aspiring for in India, and a lot of them might not have access to that. We just wanted to make sure that our products, our exciting personal care range is accessible to Pan India. Okay. It is not just a tier one product. It is not just a tier two product. It is for every Indian.
Okay.
As next steps, we are penetrating massively into the offline stores as well, so that our customers can get their products readily. They don't have to wait for 1 or 2 days for us to get it delivered. Yes. And I think, yes, we are definitely very focused in expanding international as well, because we've received some tremendous response from the global markets. People have just gone crazy as you went that this is a coffee yes. cup, which is actually present in your bathrooms.
I saw your scrubs also. It has a raw coffee.
Yes.
I saw
it's actually pure Arabica coffee. And it's very, very soft. All the particles are freshly grounded, and we make sure that they are completely round.
You use
them
raw. That's how it yeah. is.
So you can just see. I'm not sure.
I can. Yeah.
This is the kind of powder we have.
Wow.
And you just put up a few drops of water, or you can just have a shower first and then apply it on your body.
When I saw it in my cousin's bathroom, I really got misunderstood, and I thought, why is he keeping coffee bathroom mein? What is wrong with him? Is he hiding it from us? What is wrong and all that? But coming to beauty products, are we going to see you also enter the space of with beauty? I think you have hair care, you have skin care, and you have body care. But
yes.
Would you also enter the space of makeup and essentially beauty products in that range? Something with lipsticks and lip balms and more on
lip. Lip cares, yes. Okay. Definitely. But cosmetics is something which we probably don't have the plans to go into the cosmetic space for the next 2 quarters. But yes, we feel that currently personal care is something which we have to focus on. And I think a lot of things are still pending at our end. So we're just focusing on that, making the portfolio complete and making it accessible to all the folks.
So we'll have an expansion of portfolio going further. You are with 25
yes.
products right now.
We have 50 products now,
okay.
and it would be further expanded to another 25-30 products in the coming year.
But great numbers. I think your top line would go around 300 crore, if I'm not wrong, in a very short while.
Yes.
It has just shown. I don't know how the next quarter is. We can see it listed very soon. Even Nykaa got there, so you never know.
Yes.
And
yes.
It's a very, very unique way. Last question which I want you to leave us with is this whole idea of taking coffee business into a different industry altogether. Is it going to be competitive for you, challenging, or is it going to set up a new model? Because we rarely have seen a food product or a beverage product completely shift the niche. So how are you looking at it?
For us, it's not just coffee as an ingredient.
Okay.
It is, I should say, not just caffeine as an ingredient, it is more of caffeine as a connect to with our consumers as well.
Okay.
Right. And that's how we are building the brand. It is not just the product. It is, as I mentioned, like it is the emotional and the experiential part of the brand, which goes along with the product efficacy, the
yes.
brand ethos, the product ethos. So I think definitely I think we will be setting up. We are a very differentiator brand, and we don't see people focusing on the sole ingredient, although
okay.
A very strong testimony was that in the last 2 years, almost 100 plus skincare brands have actually launched caffeine/coffee products in their portfolio.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Yeah, I was talking about the lip balm. I did see one.
Yes. But earlier, there weren't many. And we still are the category leaders. We still have a huge margin from anybody selling the coffee. Or coffee-based products at the second position.
So
because
is it going to be a difficult market for you then if people are venturing into the space now?
I think again, it all depends on the kind, I mean, on the brand, the way we are building and the way we want to connect with our consumers. It's not just the product for us.
Yes.
It's the complete experience for us. And we feel we are doing justice to our customers when it comes to efficacy of the products and the experience of
yes.
the products. And I think if as we grow further, we don't see that as a challenge. Definitely, competition definitely makes you more stronger. It makes you better, and that's something which we are always.
I have to tell you, your products actually stand out than other coffee products, because there I only see the aroma of coffee, But in your product, I can feel the caffeine and the coffee. So I think you guys are more organic and real. That is why your market is expanded and connected with people. Because just creating a make-believe aroma not working out because it goes away. Mm. But with your product, I think you just take that experience and you feel like you have. I'm telling you, not having and having is a great deal for you guys to create.
Yes, because in fact, there were times when it took a good campaign. People were calling us, people were chatting with us that, yes, I am addicted to, you know, the coffee fragrance, the feel which I get after having bath with your products, and please keep on launching these products. In fact, a lot of our products are actually there because people wanted us to launch these products, like under eye cream, foot scrubs. Who would have launched a coffee foot scrub specifically?
Yes.
But people wanted it, and that's where we launched it. And there are other products, very exciting products for the next 3 months as well, and all based on our customer demand.
Motto message that M Caffeine has, what do we know from you for the youngsters?
First, definitely get addicted to a lot of good things in your life. Get addicted to good habits. Be yourself. Be that bold, young, confident self you are. Don't change yourself. We always believe in confidence over color. We always believe that you don't have to change yourself for anybody. If people want to change you, anything in you, your hair, your color, the way you look, the way you dress, don't be. Be yourself, be the bold self, and you'll see yourself emerging more stronger.
Thank you so much, Vaishali, for making time.